Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today we're going to talk about the nature of viruses. Viruses are acellular. They have no cellular structure and so they lack most of the components of cells such as organelles, ribosomes and the plasma membrane. They are very small, filterable, obligatory intracellular parasites, meaning they cannot multiply without a living host cell. However, both of these properties, being filterable through a bacterial filter and being obligatory intracellular parasite, both these properties are shared by certain small bacteria such as some rickettsia. So viruses differ from cells in the way in which they multiply. A new cell is always formed directly from a pre-existing cell. But a new virion is never formed directly from a pre-existing virion. A complete virion, a virus, which is a complete infectious particle, consists of a genome and a protein coat. The genome contains either a DNA or an RNA, which may be single-stranded or double-stranded. Some viruses may have additional layers composed of carbohydrates, lipids, and additional proteins. When a virus replicates, it has to build entire viral particles, not only making the proteins for their capsid, but also to replicate its genetic material. The virus genome has the instructions in the form of genes to take over the host cell and build new copies of itself. This process of host cell takeover is called molecular hijacking. Thus, genome of a virus enters a host cell and directs the production of the viral components, proteins and nucleic acids needed to form a new virus particle called virions. This molecular hijacking by viruses has considerable medical significance for the development of antiviral drugs, as any drug used to interact with viral multiplication would also interfere with the functioning of the host cell and therefore would be too toxic for clinical use. Viruses differ from living cells in at least three ways. They are acellular, the nucleic acid has either DNA or RNA, but not both. In contrast, all living cells, whether prokaryotes or eukaryotes, contain both DNA and RNA. And thirdly, they require a host cell to carry out cell division and are unable to reproduce independent of cells as prokaryotes and eukaryotes do. So whether viruses are living or non-living, there has always been a debate whether the viruses are living or non-living. We know that the nucleic acids of living cells are in action all the time, unlike which viruses are inactive outside the host cells, living host cells. In this sense, they can be categorized as non-living. But once viruses enter a host cell, the viral nucleic acids become active, replicating viral genome, making new progeny viruses. In this sense, viruses are alive, and when they multiply in the host cells, they infect. From a clinical point of view, viruses are alive because they can cause infection and disease just as pathogenic bacteria, fungi, and protozoa do. So depending on one's viewpoint, a virus may be considered as an exceptionally complex aggregation of non-living chemicals or as an exceptionally simple living microorganism. The host range of viruses. Viruses can infect every type of host cells, plants, animals, fungi, protists, bacteria, and archaea. Most viruses have a particular host range, meaning they can only infect the cells of one or a few species of organisms. In rare cases, viruses can expand their host range by crossing the host species barrier. This, however, is not common, and viruses only infect specific hosts and specific cell types within those hosts. The host range is determined by the specific attachment sites on host cells, the host cell receptors, And it is also determined by the presence of particular cellular factors in a host cell, which may be required for viral multiplication. So, for the virus to infect the host cell, the outer surface of the virus must chemically interact with specific receptor sites on the surface of the cell. When multiple host cell receptors bind to multiple viral surface structures, it results in a strong association between the two. So, the viruses that infect bacteria are called bacteriophages or simply phages. For bacteriophages, the receptors may be present on bacterial cell wall, fimbriae, or the flagella. Other viruses are just identified by the host group, such as animal viruses or plant viruses. For animal viruses, the receptor sites are present on the plasma membrane. Once a cell is infected, the effects produced by the virus can vary depending on the type of virus. They may cause abnormal growth of the cell, they may cause cell death, or alter the cell's genome, or some viruses may not produce any noticeable effect. In humans, a wide variety of viruses are capable of causing infections and diseases. Some of the deadliest emerging pathogens in humans are viruses, yet we have very few treatments or drugs to deal with viral infections, making them difficult to eradicate. Viruses can be transmitted from an animal host to a human host, and they cause zoonoses. For example, the avian influenza virus, which originates in birds, can cause disease in humans. An infection of an animal by a virus that originated in a human causes reverse zoonoses. The use of viruses to treat infections has a lot of potential because of the narrow host range of viruses and their ability to kill their host cells. The idea of phage therapy using bacteriophages to treat bacterial infections was developed in France in the year 1919. So, how are viruses transmitted? Viruses can be transmitted through direct person-to-person contact, like when a person with an infectious disease touches or exchanges body fluids with someone else. These may include chickenpox or the common cold, being transmitted from person to person directly. Viral infections can also spread indirectly through airborne transmission. For example, measles virus can travel long distances and can remain suspended in air for an extended period of time. Contaminated objects have been a great route of transmission for coronavirus. Other than these, enterovirus, rotavirus, and hepatitis E virus have been associated with the transmission through food and water. Some viral infections, like rabies, can be transmitted from an animal to a person. Transmission of zoonotic viruses may occur by a variety of routes. They can either be transmitted directly or through an intermediate host. Once transmitted, these zoonotic infections can be transmitted from human to human or from human to animals. Insects like mosquitoes, ticks, and flies act as mechanical or biological vectors transmitting viral infections. These viral infections can be caused in plants by the phytophagous vectors or in vertebrates by blood feeding vectors. Malaria and dengue are two very common infections spread by mosquitoes. So let's have a look at a few differences between plant and animal viruses. So plant viruses have genetic material, mostly RNA, while the animal viruses have mostly DNA. The genetic material in plant viruses is mostly single-stranded, while in animal viruses it is double-stranded. The nucleic acid in plant viruses is linear, while in animal viruses it may be linear or circular. The plant viruses do not contain the fatty envelope, and their outer layer is of the capsid, while in case of animal viruses, there is an envelope present. Transmission of the virus in case of plant viruses occurs through the plant sap or the insects or the plasmodis matter. Plasmodis matter are basically intracellular channels which facilitate the movement of molecules like photosynthetic products, proteins, or other nutrients between the cells. In case of animal viruses, transmission can occur through endocytosis or by modifications in the protein capsid. The modifications result in the uncoating of protein capsid, which then cause the release of viral genome into the host cell. The vector in case of plant viruses is mainly insect or some other organism that feed on plants, while in case of animal viruses, the vectors may vary from protozoan to humans, or the vectors may be the arthropods. Example of plant viruses include tobacco mosaic virus, cauliflower mosaic virus, the cucumber mosaic virus, while in case of animal virus, examples include infections that may be caused by animal viruses include HIV and adenoviruses, and the viruses include rotavirus, poliovirus, which are responsible for causing different infections. Infections like AIDS and polio and influenza and rabies may be caused by the animal viruses, while in case of plant viruses, infections like leaf curling, chlorosis and blisters and necrosis and mottling are caused in plants. Plant viruses are used as vectors to enhance the quantity and the quality of plants, while in case of animal viruses, they are used in the making of vaccines. So this was all about the nature of the viruses. Thank you very much.